During a meeting with the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, the Palliative Care Association of Uganda emphasized the need to provide palliative care to patients with chronic diseases such as diabetes, cancer, and sickle cell anemia. Most of these patients are recommended by medical personnel to receive treatment while at home.
We are budgeting about 280 million shillings for palliative care, and that is only for staff. When you look at the report that was presented in the House, there is a 280 million, that is for palliative care.
Countries grappling with a shortage of palliative care services, with only 11% of patients having access to this care. In the meeting, Dr. Henry Dungu, the president and chairperson of Board Palliative Care Association Uganda, highlighted lack of funding to different hospices as the major challenge.
As a coordinating body for palliative care services in Uganda, we are faced with a number of challenges to make sure that there is universal coverage for palliative care in Uganda. Of course, the ministry will talk about our national policy, which hasn't come out yet, on palliative care. And the biggest challenge that palliative care is facing now is funding, to the extent that now we can no longer do the home-based care that we used to do. We have evidence to show that most people who are faced with life-threatening illnesses prefer to be in their homes. But now we are having the Cancer Institute crowded. We are having people dying, you know, not according to their wish.
Dungu also asked the speaker to help with the process of enacting the National Palliative Care Policy, which should be able to facilitate access to services.
The speaker is to help us spearhead having the National Palliative Care Policy expedited, to have it into Parliament. And then we have this out of the way. It's been a long journey. I used to do advocacy in other countries, and they're all borrowing from Uganda the ideas of palliative care. They have moved and they have left us behind.
Mark Donald Mwesigwa, the executive director of Palliative Care Association Uganda, says many people prefer to be treated from home, and therefore support to the different hospices will go a long way to support the sick. Different health providers, like the Cancer Institute, are overcrowded and it's impossible for them to provide adequate care to clients.
We are asking Parliament, when the Ministry is talking about budget for palliative care, is home care considered? That is my appeal.
The Speaker of Parliament, Anita Mong, asked the Ministry of Health to budget for home-based care under their palliative care program, stating that it is not good for people to suffer in pain even when they are on their deathbed.
The thing you can do as a ministry is to come to us, ask for funding. You create those home-based centers in every district. You get focal people in every district to make sure the information reaches to the public.
As well as we work hand in hand with the districts. But I think awareness is not something we have done a lot. And it's something which we are planning to really scale up and engage communities to ensure that we reach the people.
Meanwhile, Rampara County MP Amos Kankunda presented a donation of 5 million shillings from the Speaker of Parliament to support the purchase of a motorcycle to facilitate home-based care in Karamoja sub-region. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.